It is time we make sure that the new recording label and stop button stay in the correct position and size at all times. Much like the original record button, we need to add constraints to these two interface elements. First, we have to think about what we want, which is three UI elements, one beneath the other, centered on screen. They should always be in the center, regardless if we're running the app on the small iPhone or the new iPad Pro. We already have a recording button centered on the main UI view of our view controller, so we can anchor the other two views off the recording button. Let's start with the recording label. The recording label is this one here that says Tap to Record. With it selected, let's control drag diagonally to the record button. The menu that comes up is context sensitive to the direction of the drag. If you just do a straight up and down or left to right drag, you only get a subset of the constraint options. With the Shift key held down, select vertical spacing and centered horizontally. Then click Add Constraints. This means that we want to maintain the vertical spacing from the recording button to this label, and that we want the label to be centered horizontally to the record button. So how does Outer Layout know where the label needs to be on screen? It checks to see where the record button is, and places this label based on that using the two constraints that you've just set up. If you're remembering back to earlier, how I mentioned that there are two constraints needed for each axis, two for the X and two for the Y, you're correct. However, the label, much like the UI button, has an intrinsic size. So Outer Layout can figure out the height and width of the label based on the text and font of the label. So all we need to provide is where to place it along the X and Y axis. In other words, just one constraint for the X and one constraint for the Y. Let's set up the constraints of the Stop Recording button against the Tap to Record label. Once more, drag diagonally from the Stop Recording button to the Tap to Record label. With the Shift key pressed down, select vertical spacing and center horizontally. Then, click Add Constraints. We should be able to see six constraints under the Constraints section of the document outline. Your number here inside these constraints may vary a little bit from 20 to 21 to 23, and they may be a little different than mine, and that's okay. They're based on where you placed your UI elements in the storyboards when you dragged them in. Let's see if this worked. Click Run, or press Command-R, and you should see the Pitch Perfect app running on the iOS simulator. Let's try different screen orientations to see if they stay centered. We can see here that they stay centered in landscape, and we'd see the same if we switched to different iOS simulators, such as the iPad Air. We should see here that our three buttons are always centered on screen. Remember, it may seem frustrating now, but that's okay. You're just learning, and this is likely one of the first times you've tried Outer Layout. Keep at it, and it will become second nature in no time.